Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Today, of course, is the 31st of January 2017, but we're considering this February the 1st. Before we begin, we just want to let you see our beautiful sign out here from CARE. Muslims register here. Just kidding, not on our watch. Join CARE in defending religious freedom. Okay, today, CARE.com. Usually we come out here to complain about CARE and its mission and its mission statement, which it claims to be a civil liberties organization in America, to stand up for the civil liberties of the American people. I would usually come out here and tell you that we fall right into the category of those in need of civil liberties. I would usually tell you that CARE, Nihad Awad, one of its leaders, I would usually tell you that Ibrahim Hooper, who's up there hiding right now, who just gave a wonderful dissertation on nationwide, no, worldwide television. It's on Al Jazeera, it's on RT, it's on Press TV, about how CARE is standing up for the rights and filing writs of all types in the federal courts in Virginia to defend the rights of immigrants, to defend the rights of so-called religious minorities. That would be usually our statement for today. But we're not going to do that today. What we are going to do is briefly tell you about the history of movements inside of America. If you notice, for every movement in America, if you study the COINTEL program that they have, that is the counterintelligence program in America, there was one designed for each revolutionary group, movement, and organization in the United States. And it's always been like that. But I'm just going to take you back as far as 1956. 1956 is the COINTEL program for the Puerto Rican Liberation Movement, and what its design was and how it functioned and what was the result. I will admit that I was in Leavenworth, the federal penitentiary, in the 1970s. And one of the people there, little Puerto Rican guy, they had shot up the Congress in 1950. And at that time, this 1975, he had did 25 years in prison. Another one was a lady. And they asked them if they renounced certain things that they would be let out of prison. All of them said, you can keep whatever you got, and if you want to let us out, fine. But we're sticking to our ethics, sticking to our morals, and sticking to our principles. That was a COINTEL program in 1960 for the Communist Party. One statement was that there was 30,000 members of the Communist Party and 15,000 of them were federal agents. That means that the government of America talks about freedom, but if you're in America, you don't have no freedom at all, especially if you challenge the American system. That's what we are. We're part of the Sabakoon movement. We challenge the American system. We challenge it because it needs to be challenged. We challenge it because it is a system of corruption, murder, and destruction, especially on people who desire what the Constitution guarantees. No, not only the Constitution, but especially in the Declaration of Independence. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. My people have been here since 1619. We have never been granted that opportunity of life, liberty, and the freedom, or the life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. No, we have been technically victims of a system which is always in the pursuit of tyranny and suppression. We know what happened with the SDS, Students for a Democratic Society, in the 1960s. These are mainly white youth. They were murdered, sabotaged, and killed, just like set up with dope and everything, just like the black movement, which is the most popular movement for the COINTEL program, the most well-known. We were exiled, shot, killed, murdered, and sabotaged. Some are still in prison today. But I want to talk to you a little bit about our case in general. We are not only African American, but we are Muslim. And not only are we Muslims, but we are Muslims who make some effort, some small effort, to follow the Quran and the Sunnah, the guidelines of what makes a Muslim. But in that process, we also recognize the history of this country called America. In recognizing the history of America, we know how the American government treats people who want to really pursue liberty and the pursuit of happiness, especially if that happiness has anything to do with true liberation, and if that happiness does not coincide with the tyranny and the warmongering United States government. Now we're going to get to right now. We have this group right here, CARE. It has Black Lives Matter. I'm not going to show you all the photos and all the pictures and all the history. In the last few days, everybody is jumping up and down about the civil liberties of refugees, of Muslims coming into the country from outside of the country, and they should have their historical or some rights of justice. And CARE is one of the main perpetrators of it. I was reading a little bit about poor Nihad's history, born in a refugee camp in Jordan, and he's happy to be here in America, in the land of freedom. This is what he says. We have Ibrahim Hooper up there, who came down here from Canada. They're for immigrants' rights. But you are looking at people right now on camera who have been arrested in their own buildings, taken out to county jails and brutalized. When it says Black Lives Matter and I can't breathe, you're looking at one of the people who survived that I can't breathe ism from the system called the United States government. You are looking at an independent people. But that independence is a miracle because of the financial schemes and raids on assets, fines, all types of illegal issues brought up in the courts to take our money. We've been held up. They got people been held up at the airports here. I've been held up in Johannesburg for 2 days. I've been taking off planes right here recently. Just go down the gangplank and they come tell you, come on back. And they tell you, you stand there. And I said, what the hell is wrong with you? Stand there. I'm almost, well, that time I'm 70 years old. Or, there's a brother here that put me on the plane, so they thought in Las Vegas. I called back and said, come pick me up at the Nevada, Las Vegas County Jail. I'm sitting up in the jail. Why I ain't going on the plane? The people say, you stand there and you be quiet. I said, I'm a customer here. And you can't talk to me like that. That you must be crazy. They called the police and said, this man is talking. What they said. And the police tells me, you have to be quiet. And I tell him that he is literally crazy. There's no sign in this. This is in the airport in Vegas. You know the people have been gambling and crazy and drunk, and they loud as they can be. And he's telling me, who's talking normally, that I have to be quiet. And for that, since I didn't feel like being quiet, not only I didn't see a sign, and I asked him, where is this silent sign around here? And everybody else is talking. You got to go tell them to be quiet first. Now, if every one of these people in this airport shut up, keep their mouth closed. Well, I'll do it just for the heck of it. But you got to get all of them quiet first. So they take me to jail. I could stand here all day about hassles in the airport, coming in to the airport, held up for 4 hours in customs, questioned by the FBI, NSA, and anybody else that want to come, because I'm coming into the country. And they can confiscate anything that they want and photograph money. They go just out and out crazy. Now, with all that going on, with being beat up by the police, okay, yes, right over there. What's that, the 6th District? And the same day, I'm drug over to the county, the city jail down here. And they worked their brother over there. Worked their brother over. Now, I ain't no crybaby. I don't come out and say, man, they worked their brother over. I said, the crackers did this, that, and another. And that's fine. Because a little butt kicking ain't nothing. This is normal treatment. We go and ask Dear Care, hey, man, why don't you give us some legal advice or just listen to our story? And they want to help everybody else in the world, whether immigrants, whether you come in to visit the country, green card holder. Hell, I'm a citizen of this United States. I got a passport. I got all kind of IDs to say, I even got a birth certificate from Arkansas with a state seal on it. Got a passport with a U.S. seal on it. I am a citizen of the United States. I'm not no visitor from outside. Now, when I go to Nehat and Brother Hooper, they had no news conference about us. Funny thing is, I can't even get up there to talk to them. They got the door locked. Even if I make an appointment, hey man, we at this conference, it's 11/20/2016. Hey, can I come by and holler at you? Sure, come on by. I'll give you a call before I come. I called the wonderful Care. I don't know what happened to the call. Maybe it went somewhere else. I just did it 3, 4, maybe 5 times. And I said, well, maybe you don't want to talk to me. Now, This is the fifth time we've been out here jumping up and down and turning flips. Now, if he really cared, if CARE really cared, they would at least walk outside and say, Imam Musa, what's happening, man? What's going on? And all I would say is, hey, man, I just want to show you a little paperwork, a little history, you know, what's been going on. And you just give me, you a legal bunch up here, just give me a little pointers on what you think I ought to do. Or if you feel like I deserve it, you can even, just because you filed a case yesterday, rapidly, they call it lickety-split. That means right away, right? Now, I got a stack of cases over the years, well-recorded, photographed, chronicalized, and I can't get no advice. But if somebody come from Syria, which we support now, but they from over there. And I've been here, and my parents been here far back as we can remember. So you can help everybody else, but you can't help citizens? And what is it, color? Maybe it's color, I wanna know. Why? Here's what I was told, I don't know. They told me that the government of America has a program called Shaping and Herding, that through constant contact and psychological probes and innuendos, there is a management process of the government that when they interact with you as an individual, a group, a movement, or an organization over a long period of time, they can begin to affect your behavior. That is shaping. The herding comes when this whole series of events is organized around a situation. It's multicultural, multi-ethnic, and it has all types and kinds of people associated with it. Shaping and herding comes in when you are herded, your behavior is shaped. They do this, you move over there. They do that, you move over there. They do this right here, then you move over there. They're shaping your behavior. That's what the government does. Then they herd you, just like herding cattle, along a certain way. Decades ago, the United States government knew that it was going to have to deal with the Muslim population in America. Now, the most well-behaved group of people in America by the millions is considered Mormons and Muslims. Say the most well-behaved citizens in America are Mormons and Muslims. Number one, they don't have too many accidents for drunk driving because Mormons don't drink and Muslims don't drink, right? Most of the Muslims in America are pretty well educated. Most of them are employed. Therefore, they're not robbing liquor stores. They're not using drugs. They're not involved in that type of behavior. But the Zionist power structure in America, coupled with Saudi Arabia and the American system itself, looked ahead and they saw that there'll be a strong Muslim population in America. Therefore, we want to control them 100%. And we are going to do all types of activities to, number one, change the picture, the image that the people of America have of Islam. So after a few arranged terrorist plots bombings, assassinations that they blame on the Muslims, but they were done by the Zionists in America, right? That after that series of events, the American people get a picture of Islam as a terrorist entity. The only thing was that backfired. We got Islamophobia, but we also got Dear Donald Trump. Now, he helped out a lot. Everybody else is afraid of Donald Trump. We think he's a credit to the movement. Hey there, bro. Can you hear us? All right. We just speaking out for freedom and justice. We are good American citizens. Thank you. And we believe that every individual in the United States should be able to participate in life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. May I backtrack just for 1 second? The Declaration of Independence also says that any government that infringes on that right, freedom, justice, and equality, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, that it is the duty, it is actually the responsibility for the people to change that tyranny to a government of liberty. Now anyway, getting a little tired out here, but not really, I'm just playing. Let's get to the point. The reason CARE don't take any cases that the government of the United States don't like is because CARE is said to have been created by Saudi Arabia, that's Prince Bandar, the Zionists, and the American FBI, CIA. That's what they've been doing all along. And that they are there to help shape the behavior and push the people into the American system. Now, if you look at Homeboy right there, he's talking about voting and everything else. Isn't that right? He has Black Lives Matter up there. But we're black. What about us? We are Muslims. What about us? I get a feeling that there is a Negro car full of colored folks. Maybe. I don't know whether they're coming this way. But if they come, I mean Muslim. Man, that's good. Wa alaykum salam. You know why we out here?
See how wonderful Allah works?
You know, Allah Akbar.
See you anyway.
Allah Akbar. Well, the reason we out here is because CARE says they care. They got a Black Lives Matter sign in there. And we have had more contact with the FBI, the CIA, than anybody in the United States. And CARE, who says they care, will not even answer our phone calls. So this is about the fifth time. No, we putting it all on everything because we want the world to know. If you're supposed to stand up for the rights of the people, then what's wrong with us, right? If you for Black Lives Matter, not only we black, but we Muslim too, right? And as far as I can't breathe, I'm the only imam in the United States that's been arrested in his own masjid with the deed on the table, taken out to a county jail facilities, and given those old type of Negro whippings they used to give us. You know. Yeah, I mean, it's all right. Not only that, D.C. did it too. The 6th District did it, and downtown, all in one day. Now, I was 68 or 69 years old at that time. Now I'll be 72 next month. But here's something. The Declaration of Independence promises us something. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, right? Well, And that means no government agency should interfere with this process of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, right? Then it goes on to say that any government that infringes on, it is the duty, is what the Declaration of Independence says, right? It's the duty of that people to change that government, okay? Now, we're not talking about the whole government. We're talking about an organization that files all types of writs for immigrants and people who have one little problem here and one little problem there, and you see them on TV. Now, Nihad Awad is supposedly a friend of mine, Ibrahim Hooper, but you can see the windows, they up there, they won't even come to the window. This is supposed to be a friend of ours. Why? It's because the United States government has taken over the Islamic movement in North America. That's the problem. Yes. Right.
You know, what we doing, ironic, because I had to come and see you. This is Officer Kevin Johnson. He's Muslim.
All right. Assalamu alaikum, brother. How is everything?
We met before.
All right. Yes,
this
yes.
This is Minister Thomas Bowen.
All right. My pleasure.
Director of Religious Affairs. So what they have us doing is we go around to all of the masjids or Islamic places in the city.
Right.
To kind of talk about.
You put this on, let everybody know in the world. It's what we're trying to do. It's for good, right?
Right.
Do you mind if we?
So what the mayor has asked us to do, the chief of police, is go around to all Islamic organizations, centers, masjids, and to make them aware of MPD's commitment to making sure that incidents such as one in Quebec doesn't touch us. So they just want everyone to be vigilant, paying attention to, surrounding. Say, hypothetically, if you come out of the masjid, out of Islam, you notice there's a truck or something there that's out of place, or the individuals is out of place, no matter who they are, then MPD wants you to know that you can reach out to them and we'll have someone check it out.
The police department have brothers, uniformed officers that come to do.
Right, exactly.
Now me, I'm from California. Now I told everybody when I came here, you can ask your brothers in Juma. I say, y'all may not like the D.C. police, but I said, I'm from California. I said, the D.C. police does not go around with the desire, let me shoot a Negro today.
Right.
But in California, this is common. When they talk about Black Lives Matter,
right,
them European uneducated police, the people say, I can't understand why somebody would shoot a person for nothing, for running away. Because he wants to shoot you. Now, I ain't like that about it. We don't have no problem with the D.C. D.C. is fine. Every now and then, they listen to the NSA. And NSA tells the police that we are a terrorist organization. Now, of course, you see how we terrorize people during Ramadan, all the food we give them, right?
Right?
I mean, you're part of the city apparatus. Have you ever seen us do anything against anybody? When you have Muslim and Christian meetings, are we there? When we want to do some march or help the poor, are we there? Okay. Do we get along very well? Who's the sister in our area? City council lady. She's gone. I know she's been gone, but we had good contact. We don't have no problem. We have no problems with the police department, D.C. They didn't work us over a couple of times, but that's the NSA telling them to do that. But the department itself is not a problem at all for us. It's only the NSA and the FBI, when they tell them, see, the police come, D.C. police come to Juma with their uniform on. Okay, they know. I mean, they listen to the khutbah and they just regular police officers who are listening. They know we ain't doing nothing. But when they get an order from the NSA or something like that, then an officer has to follow that. So that's the only problem we have is if the D.C. Police Department follows the information that it has. It has an intelligent network. It has, I mean, it infiltrates me. It knows what we're doing, right? We ask them to follow that, follow what their department finds out. Right. Don't let somebody come from over there in Virginia and say, these people are doing this, and these people are doing that. Anyway, I really appreciate that. And,
brother, man, I know what you've been doing. I've seen I've seen the transformation.
And years ago, right there at Benning Road and C Street, remember when we moved there? It was cars parked. Remember the apartments over there? They was full of drugs and drug dealers. Now, it's all gone, you know. Now, we ain't going kicking in doors telling people to stop, but what we try to do is influence. Sometimes we out with a speaker, just like this, talking for a few minutes. We ain't gonna bore people to death and beat them over the head with this mouth. But you'd have seen yourself in Ramadan, the people in the apartments around is looking out their window to see, okay, the table is about moving down, so let's go over and get ours, right? It's time to eat. And come on over. That's what you, we're part of the community. Oh, it's mine? Well, I ain't worried about it. Okay, thank you very much, brother. We are, all right, we're in sync, huh? No, they'll let y'all in, because y'all got badges, and y'all got all kind of, y'all look official. Okay, what we're gonna do is now, we're gonna close up, we're gonna come back maybe tomorrow or the next day. But we wanna remember, let you know, if Black Lives Matter, then what about us? You can see we black. If there's Islamophobia going on in America and we're trying to help with it, why do everyone who's based here in America want to help immigrants from Syria and immigrants from all over the world, from Iraq, but they don't want to pay any legal attention to us here at all? So today, we thank all of y'all for paying attention and listening, and now we're gonna go back to the wonderful Southeast DC, although this is technically Southeast, you just wouldn't know it. We're going back home. Maybe we'll be back in a couple of days, because we gotta finish telling you that CARE is a creation of the United States government. Just like the government has taken over ISNA, ICNA, and all of our groups, including our dear friends from Iran. Just want to let y'all know.
Brother Dan?
Yes, thank you very much.
All right. I will see you in Shalom this week.
All right, thank you very much. So, okay, we greet y'all, leave y'all with the great greeting. Assalamu alaikum.